Ladies, in a few seconds we'll be sipping on some Chris and watching the 2003 MTV Movie Awards.
Quit playing around, Sean.
I'm not, dude. My key won't fit.
You must be the ones.
Oh, cool. This is super.
Actually, I'm the key maker.
Don't worry. You'll be inside in just a moment.
Awesome. Thanks.
What's happening, hot stuffs?
Dude!
Where the hell are we?
You're in Zion, baby!
What is this place?
Duh! It's obviously an underground city where the last remaining humans live and the robots are coming to kill us. Doesn't that just make you want a party?
Yeah!
Dude, let's get out of here.
I don't know, man. These girls are pretty hot. Check it out. You can totally see their nipples.
Oh my god, there's Morpheus! He's having a huge orgy at his place later tonight. At least that's what many of us have heard.
It is true what many of you have heard.
Morpheus! What can we expect at this orgy?
Machines!
Man, I'm out.
Sounds kind of kinky.
I'll see you guys there! And bring plenty of lube!
What?
Nothing.
Great. An infinite hallway of doors.
One of these has to lead back to your apartment.
You know what? You try that one. I need to use this one.
Something happens, something bad, and she starts to fall. And then I wake up.
Now that's f***ed up.
I'm so sorry to interrupt you guys, but I'm really lost.
Wait a minute. You're that boy from NSYNC. What happened to your Jerry curl, man? That was a good look. Yeah, that was hot. You know them boys, right?
I've never heard of them.
You never heard of NSYNC?
No.
Those boys can dance. Come on, man, show them your moves.
You have to?
I'm the Oracle, damn it.
If I had to guess, I'd say you're a program from the machine world.
Nah, man, I'm just doing the robot. Here, you should try it.
Yeah, work it. Come on, Neo, get in there, man. Do the robot.
Why?
Come on, man, you're the one. You can do it all.
No.
Come on, man. No more origato, Mr. Roboto.
You can do the robot with JT.
What if I can't? What happens if I fail?
Okay, dude, lighten up for real. It's just the robot.
No. I can't do that. I won't.
Well, hell, I will. Talk to me, boy. Don't be scared.
Oh, God.
Ooh. Come on, do the part. Do the naked part.
Mr. Timberlake.
Mr. William Scott.
Hey, you're that guy that got peed on an American... Ooh, you hitting the spot. How big is your fist? Good Lord. Hey, wait a minute, man. This is dry clean only.
You'll like being a dude. I do.
That is a load of Stiflers.
Farted.
Charles, focus. Let's get Mr. Timberlake.
What really, Mr. Timberlake?
Ow! Justin, you really hit me. That is so not cool.
Oh.
Hello. I've been waiting for you three.
Who are you?
Yeah, who are you?
I am the architect. But please, call me Larry.
Hey, Larry.
Larry.
I created The Matrix and several popular video games, including Qbert and Dig Dug.
Remember that?
Yeah.
I didn't create Frogger, but I came up with the name for it. Can you believe they wanted to call it Highway Crossing Frog?
That is so lame.
I know. It's the lamest thing I've ever heard of. Highway Crossing Frog.
Why am I here?
Yeah, why are we here?
Is there an echo in here? The MTV Movie Awards are a systemic anomaly inherent to the programming of The Matrix. Although the transport process has altered your consciousness, you irrevocably remain human. Ergo, concordantly, vis-a-vis. You know what? I have no idea what the hell I'm saying. I just thought it would make me sound cool.
You haven't answered my question.
I'm feeling a little vulnerable right now, so you just need to chill out. Can you do that? I'd appreciate that. Thank you. Now, originally Neo was the chosen one to host the show, but hosting is a full-time commitment, and he's been a little distracted lately.
Trinity.
See what I'm talking about? That's why I brought in Sean and Justin. Because you, my friend, are completely pussy-whipped.
Oh!
Bullshit.
Watch the sass, Captain Sassy Pants.
Yeah, you're kind of spazzing out, dude.
You haven't answered my question.
Yes, I did. You see, what
You haven't answered my...
I'm trying. You just need to let me talk.
Why am I here?
Would you shut up?
You won't let it...
No, you won't let it! I'm the one who talks! Okay, mouth shut! Ears open!
You haven't answered.
You do not want to see me get out of this chair! Erica, open your yapper one more time, and I'm gonna architect a world of pain all over your candy ass! Ergo! Vis-a-vis!
This is about...
Concordantly!
Justin.
Yeah?
I apologize. I don't usually like to use my big voice.
That's all right, dog. Just tell us how we get to the movie awards.
There are two doors. The door on your left leads Sissy Boy here back to his bitch. What up, G? You can't handle it. The door on your right leads you to the 2003 MTV Movie Awards. And the mini door is for Muffin to go out and piddle. What? Hey. No. You are bizarre.
Thanks, Lair.
Don't mention it. Oh, and hey. Go host the shit out of that show.
Boom.
If I were you...
Bite your tongue. Bite it.
I would hope that we don't meet again.
Why'd you say that? I told you to shut up.
I told you to shut up!
Greetings, true believers. Prepare yourself for an amazing, spine-tingling, heart-stopping yarn, the likes of which the world has never known. The 2003 MTV Movie Awards! Issue 1.
Captain Jansen!
we're here to present the award for Breakthrough Female Performance.
That's right. A lot of today's brightest stars got their start by winning this very award.
Excuse me, Mr. Jackman, Ms. Jansen. Quick question, please.
Sure.
Yeah, right.
Go for it.
First of all, amazing movie. One minor problem. And by minor, I mean major. The writers appear to have made Banshee a little girl when, as we all know, Banshee has always been and always will be a man.
Okay, well, obviously you haven't read X-Force issue number 3, right?
Yes, but, well...
Well, if you'd read it, you would know that the little girl was, in fact, Siren, Banshee's daughter, who's endowed with similar powers.
Yes.
Any more questions?
Dear, no, ma'am. Sorry.
All right.
Anyway, here are the nominees for Breakthrough Female Performance.
Man, Sean, I love being a superhero, huh?
X-ray Vision rocks the his house.
Word up.
You said it, Pee-wee.
Breakthrough Female, Nia Vardalos, My Big Fat Greek Wedding.
Oh! You invited the whole family?
Ew.
Beyonce Knowles, Austin Powers in Goldmember.
Cause I'm Foxy Cleopatra, and I'm a whole lot of woman.
Maggie Gyllenhaal, Secretary.
I have never had a job before, but I am very excited about this opportunity.
Eve, Barbershop.
I can't believe you got somebody up in here. Who drank my apple juice?
Jennifer Garner, Daredevil.
I didn't get your name.
My name is Elena.
Remember me.
What do you want?
I just wanted to get your name.
Kate Bosworth, Blue Crush.
The pipe is the heaviest wave in the world. Okay, you don't just get work there. You die.
And the breakthrough female is...
Jennifer Garner. Daredevil.
One of the night. I've always wanted one of these. I had so much fun making it, so thank you to all the people in MTV land for giving this award to me. Thanks to everybody who helped make the movie and to my co-stars, Colin and Ben, for walking me through it. Thanks.
Thanks very much. I'm so excited. Thanks, you guys.
Coming up next, Will Smith, Martin Lawrence, Colin Farrell,
hello,
Samuel L. Jackson, and the award for Best Comedic Performance.
Hi, how are you kids?
When the 2003 MTV Movie Awards continues, please welcome Martin Lawrence and Will Smith.
Big Will, Big Will. Let me ask you a question. You're a bad boy, right?
Yeah, I guess so. You're a bad boy too, right?
You think the nominees in this category are bad boys too?
Yeah, I guess, you know, they're bad boys too.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I guess they're bad boys too, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah, July 18th.
Why'd you just say July 18th?
What are you talking about? I say, I guess they're bad boys too.
No, you said, I guess they're bad boys too. Then you said July 18th. Why'd you say that?
Why are you bugging,
I'm
man?
I'm bugging, I'm asking all a question. Right?
Now you being a bad boy.
No, you being a bad boy too, boy, I'm telling you. Seriously, stop playing. Now, come on, let's just give out this bad boy, you know. Here are the bad boys nominated for Best Comedic Bad Boy Performance, July 18th.
Hey, how's everybody doing here tonight? I just flew in. Literally. So, woohoo! Talk about kryptonite. You should try my wife's cooking.
You suck.
Whoa!
Best comedic performance, Will Ferrell, Old School.
We're going streaking!
What are you guys, like, better, nurse?
Hey, honey!
Or cheerleader?
Adam Sandler, Mr. Deeds.
Oh, you're sick! Why would you do that to me? I'm just kidding you, pal.
Cedric the Entertainer, Barbershop.
OJ did it. Rosa Parks ain't do nothing but sit her black hair down.
Mike Myers, Austin Powers in Goldmember.
That's just disgusting.
Yes, yeah, nice to meet you.
Johnny Knoxville, Jackass the Movie.
Hello, I'm Johnny Knoxville, and we're about to test my rocket skates.
And the winner is Mike Myers.
Austin Powers.
They are bad boys too, aren't they? Happy July 18th, you bad boys, two of ya. Come on. Huh? Some people I'd like to thank. I'd like to thank all of you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. I would like to thank MTV. I would like to thank Jay Roach, Michael McCullers, all the people at New Line, Beyonce Knowles. I would also like to thank the cast and crew. I would also like to thank my wife, Robin. I love you very much. And I would like to thank and pay tribute to Mr. Burt Bacharach, who is a comedy, a musical genius, for all the comedy that comes through me, comes through his music. So thank you very much. Bye-bye.
Ladies and gentlemen, the stars of the upcoming film SWAT, Samuel L. Jackson and Colin Farrell.
Hello. Although the MTV Movie Awards does not endorse violence, I must have missed the point of Jackass. We would like to recognize the following fight sequences for their artistic merit.
Yeah, right. You know, sometimes it's just good to see a motherfucker get the shit kicked out of him.
Motherfucker!
Yeah.
Here are the nominees for best fight.
Whoa!
Nothing to see here, people.
Best fight. Fan Wong versus the Palace Intruders, Shanghai Knights. Yoda versus Christopher Lee, Star Wars Episode II, Attack of the Clones. Jet Li versus the Ultimate Fighters, Cradle to the Grave. Johnny Knoxville versus Butterbee, Jackass the Movie.
Give me once, at least. There you go. And the award for best fight goes to my man, Yoda and Christopher Lee.
This is Yoda's first nomination and first MTV Movie Award.
Grateful am I to this award receive. To win, I did not expect. The following people thank I must. Christopher Lee, regret not training you. Always will you be a Padawan to me. George Lucas, GL, eye to eye we did not always see, but immense you are and love you still I do. Samuel Jackson, Sammy gifted are you. Natalie Portman, wise beyond your years you seem. Promise myself, cry, I would not. Others to thank. Watto, Chewie, Tanui, Vin Diesel, R2-D2, C-3PO, Björk, Greedo, Steve Gutenberg, Ki-Adi-Mundi, Yaddle, Lamassu. Play off Yoda, no one does. To all the younglings at MTV, thank I do. 900 years old Yoda may be, but that does not mean down he is not. Many languages I speak, and one of them is yours. Representing for you and all my peeps on Dagobah will always Yoda be. Last, least not, to the one who rules this earth, respect I pay. Long live your queen, Latifah.
Colin.
Awesome, as usual.
Oh, Yoda, my homie.
Always great to share the stage with
Yoda,
the Green Man. Next time you will.
Still to come.
You're a bad boy. I'm a good boy.
Maya, Mark Wahlberg, Adrian Brody.
Where's Brody?
And Pink performs her new hit from Charlie's Angels, Full Throttle, and the award for Best Kiss. When the 2003 MTV Movie Awards continue.
Well, when we decided to make a sequel to Charlie's Angels, we didn't want it to just be another popcorn movie. We wanted to make a film that would truly stand the test of time.
And this time we knew the movie needed more qualities necessary to resonate on a sociological level.
Mm. In other words, more ass.
When the girls came to me with the concept of adding more ass sequences to Angels 2, it sounded pretty complicated. I knew if we wanted to pull it off, we'd have to bring in an expert, someone who really knew the ins and outs of it all.
Who put a nickel in that ass? Well, chances are, if you've seen an ass in a film, I'm the man behind it. Literally. Well, I like to think that instead of pulling ideas out of my own ass, I pull them out of other people's asses. Drew has, I call it the Mona Lisa ass. What's your secret? Slight smile. I want to know more. I can't stop looking at you. And Lucy got that bad ass, that naughty ass. I want to slap that ass and say, you go to bed, ass. There's no TV for you tonight, ass.
When you're working with someone who has as much experience as Frank, you know your ass is in good hands.
Cameron, sporty ass. Let's volley for serve. You know what I mean? Let's roughhouse.
Nick, I'm gonna ask you to hold it.
All right, let's cut. Cut it.
Cameron?
Yeah.
You're better than that.
Sorry.
Okay, now if you could be so kind as to back that ass up just a tad. Now I'm gonna ask you to very slowly drop it like it's hot.
Yes, it is.
Back to one roll sound. Keep it sizzling, all of you. Let's get some sizzling here. Nick G, believe me, you're gonna thank me for it. An ass is a lot like a pinata. Until you bust that open, you don't know what little toys are gonna bust out of there. Do you know what I mean? What you're gonna get your hands on. Sometimes it's a pleasant surprise, sometimes it's like, who stocked this pinata? I'm not interested. Let's go over to the watering hole. Well, I first realized this was my calling. I was working as a grip on the film Roadhouse. I was on the set the day Patrick Swayze was filming his now famous Out From Under the Sheet scene, and it was then that I saw the light.
I remember this kid turning to the director and saying, there is entirely too much light on Swayze's ass. That kid's name was Frank Fanning, and he's been lighting me up from the rear ever since.
Is that on the screen or is that on Cameron's ass? That's the screen. Is that Cameron's ass? That's the screen.
It's the screen.
That's the screen.
And...
hold it, G. You're looking a little flaccid, Luce.
I'm trying.
Come on, Luce, dig deeper. Yeah, I don't know how long I can hold this.
Damn it, Lou, you can do this. You were clinching circles around everyone during rehearsals. I'm not just blowing smoke up your ass.
I'm sorry, Frank. I just don't think I'm gonna be able to get it into gear.
Okay. Take a deep breath. I meant through your ass.
I tried everything I could. My ass was just blocked.
When Lucy went soft, she took it really hard.
Pussy, are you in there? Come on, Luce, open the door.
Claire!
But when she was able to squeeze one of Frank's balls in her ass,
you know how to concentrate with her stomach.
She was really able to concentrate and find her in her strength.
You can do this, okay?
Okay.
McG, it's your set.
Her ass was back on its feet in no time. I have to admit, when we finally sat down and watched the movie, it was everything we imagined it would be. And more.
Definitely.
And there's truly only one person to thank for that.
Well, when you work with a bunch of dedicated professionals who allow you to play and experiment with their asses as much as these young ladies did, it makes your job pretty darn easy.
That's so sweet, Frank.
Looking back, there were a lot of challenges along the way, but I'd have to say the biggest challenge on this film was saying goodbye. Goodbye to you. Goodbye to you. Goodbye to you. And I'll see you soon. You know I will. I'll be on your ass.
Thank you.
One of our next presenters recently posed for the cover of FHM magazine. The other recently masturbated to it. Please welcome my buddies from American Wedding, Allison Hannigan and Jason Biggs.
Everyone knows the saying, there's no I in team.
That's right. T-E-A-M equals...
Together everyone achieves more.
Yes, a team is less me...
And more we.
Because a job is worth doing...
Is worth doing together.
Would you stop finishing my goddamn sentences?
Sorry.
Here are the nominees...
For best on-screen team.
Okay.
Dude, we've got to get backup costumes.
True dat, true dat.
Best on-screen team.
Go time!
Luke Wilson, Will Ferrell, and Vince Vaughn. Old school.
We can't have anyone freak out there, okay? Gotta keep our composure!
Kate Bosworth, Michelle Rodriguez, and Sonoy Lake. Blue Crush.
Hurry up, go get her, again. Come on. Woo!
Jackie Chan and Owen Wilson. Shanghai Knights.
You see that?
It's okay.
Okay.
Friends to the end, John.
I clothesline the sucker.
Elijah Wood, Sean Astin, and Gollum. The Lord of the Rings, The Two Towers.
Don't take it to him.
Johnny Knoxville, Bam Margera, Steve-O, and Chris Pontius. Jackass, the movie.
And the best on-screen team is... Elijah Wood, Sean Astin, and Gollum, Lord of the Rings, Two Towers. Foolish.
It's funny to accept a word for a team when this is a really dysfunctional team. Considering our relationship with Gollum is slightly skewed.
All you need is a leader, a stinker, and somebody who likes to eat.
You know, thank you so much, guys. This is awesome. And I think in some ways we're actually getting this award for being friends, because a lot of our friendship went into the role, so.
I'd agree with that.
So thank you very much. This is awesome. Sean? Do you want to hold it?
Yeah, I want to hold the popcorn. What can you say? Thank you very much, everybody. It rocks. Well, there's so many people who went into creating this team, including Mr. Tolkien.
That's right.
Professor Tolkien and Peter Jackson and New Line and...
That's
I think
right.
37 people just yelled Andy Serkis. We love you, Andy, wherever you are, you little stinker. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you, guys.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Princess of Darkness, Sharon Osbourne.
got to speak. Okay. I love you too. In Mexico, he's known as Cinco Peso. In Russia, his fans call him 15 rubles. In Denmark, depending on the markets, he's 3 corona. But in the United States of America, he's simply 50 cents.
It's your birthday. We don't sip a Bacardi like it's your birthday. And you know we don't give up. It's not your birthday. You find me in the club. Bottle full of bum. Yeah. I got what you need. If you need to fill a buzz. I'm in the habit of sex. I'm in the making love. So come get me a hug. Get the kid wood. Me in the club, bottle full of bub. Grandma, I got what you need. If you need to fill a buzz, I'm in the habit of sex. I ain't in the making love. So come give me a hug. Get in the get rough. When I pull up out front, see the Benz on dub. When I roll 20 deep, it's always drama in the club. You can turn off the drain, now they wanna show me love. When you sound like Eminem, you get plenty of groupie love. Look, homie, ain't nothing changed. Oh, damn, Jesus. I see you sipping in the cutting, man. If you watch how I move, you mistake me for a player. Been hit with a few shit, but I walk with a limp. In the hood, and LA, they say 50, you hot. They like me, I want them to love me like they love pop. But I'm in New York, for show, they tell you I'm loco. And the plan is to put the rap game in a choke. I'm really focused, man. My money on my mind, got a bill of the deal, and I'm still on the ground. Now, y'all, since you feelin' my stats, she feelin' my flow. I'm here to put it in mind, they ready to go. Full of bub, but I got what you need. If you need to fill a bug, I'm in the having sex, I ain't in the making love. So come give me a hug, you're in the getting rough. You can find me in the club, bottle full of bub, but I got what you need. If you need to fill a bug, I'm in the having sex, I ain't in the making love. So come give me a hug, you're in the getting rough. Whoa. My flow, my show, gon' be that wrong. Only you hate it, oh, you mad. I thought that you been happy, I made it. I'm the cat by the bar, toasted to the good. You that f***ing ass, you're trying to pull me back. So my show get the bumping in the club, it's on. I wink my eye at your chick, it's just not she gone. If the roof gone by, man, just let it burn. If they're talking about money, homie, I ain't concerned. I'ma tell you what banks told me, cause go ahead, switch the style. And if they hate, then let them hate. Watch the money pile up. You need, if you need to fill a bug, I'm in the habit of sex, I ain't in the making love. So come give me a hug, you're in the getting rough. You can find me in the club, bottle full of bug. I got what you need, if you need to fill a bug, I'm in the habit of sex, I ain't in the making love. So come give me a hug, you're in the getting rough.
Put your hands up. It's your birthday, can't see you now.
She's so fine, I got a bigger mind. I ass like that, gotta be.
Come on,
I crush your baby.
Come on,
put you with heavy.
Come on,
I'm them with that.
Come on,
I make them press right. They know they can't shine. If I'm a runner, I've been up for months since 95, cause I commit the crime. I say in my lines, I did a 3 to 9. The D's run up in my crib, you know who dropped the gun. You say you were gangsta, but you never. You say you were waste up, and you need to
stop front.
You never
cop, no.
You been hustling a long time and you ain't got
enjoy myself more than they enjoy me. Stop.
Oh, hi. Didn't see you there.
Up next, Ashton Kutcher, P. Diddy.
MTV, y'all know how to throw a great motherfucking party.
Paul Walker.
This is the real star right here.
Tyrese.
I'm doing security for him.
And the award for
best villain.
Stunt.
When the 2003 MTV Movie Awards continue.
Goodbye!
Sorry about that. Please welcome our next two presenters.
From Too Fast, Too Furious.
Paul Walker.
And Tyrese.
Yo, man, I'm real tired of these people coming out here plugging their movies, man. What if we came up here talking about Too Fast, Too Furious, huh?
Shameless.
Huh?
Shameless.
Just what if that happened, Paul? What if I just came up out of my clothes and start talking about Too Fast, Too Furious, man?
It's shameless. June 6th, but it's shameless. Anyways. Here are the nominees for Best Action Sequence. Whoa. Hey, can I see that again, Justin?
Fine.
Thanks, dude.
Ain't no thang but a G-string on a chicken wing.
Best Action Sequence. Minority Report. Destination 2. Star Wars Episode 2, Attack of the Clones. The Lord of the Rings, The Two Towers.
And the best action sequence is, the honors are by my little brother right here. Give it up for Savon, yo. Wave at the people, man. Wave at the people. Yeah. The Lord of the Rings, The Two Towers, director Peter Jackson.
Wow, well, this is amazing. I'd just like to thank everybody at MTV for this incredible award. The Battle of Helm's Deep was a really arduous scene to shoot, and special thanks to John Mahaffey, our second unit director, and all his crew, and the great stunt guys that did such an amazing work. And of course the actors, you know, Viggo Mortensen, Bernard Hill, they were, you know, they had to be trained up, and quite frankly, I really taught Viggo all that he knows about fighting. In fact, I had to double Viggo in quite a few of the scenes that he did. And Bernard Hill, well, I mean, he fights like a girl, so I had to double him as well. So, you know, they were doing their best, and they were...
Yeah.
Hi, guys.
Hey,
guys, we just won this award, and I was saying how great you were.
Oh,
you know,
yeah.
You were really good. I was just telling the folks at MTV just how incredibly wonderful you fought.
Let this be the hour when we draw swords together.
This cowboy bastard was a front.
Yeah.
I think it's great.
Listen, we've got a couple ideas we want. I know we're going on.
Yeah, you're on next section.
Right, so we wanted to talk to you about a couple ideas we had just for our intro.
To make it a little bit hotter.
Okay.
So here's the thing. See, we wanted to start off on a yacht. Us on a yacht with hot chicks drinking champagne.
In Saint-Tropez.
Okay,
we're on the yacht, and then mermaids are serving us.
Okay, so...
And then they say to us... MTV Movie Awards needs you.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
The mermaid says to me. They say it like it wouldn't even go, the show wouldn't even happen without us.
Exactly. That's what they say, right?
Right. Yeah.
So we're like,
hell
okay.
Yeah.
You know what we do? We jump off of the yacht.
Jump off the yacht.
Onto dolphins.
Tell them.
We ride them from Saint-Tropez
to LA.
We jump off the dock horse onto
like
the stage.
Worldwide.
Money starts raining down onto us. 2-3 million on us. Boom, there you have it. Diddy and Ashton, hello.
You know what? I can't do any of this. I can't do it. I'm sorry.
What you talking about?
Listen, I can get the hot girl from Chasing Papi to introduce you.
Hold on one second. Yeah, you definitely got it.
Deal.
Oh,
yeah,
good.
We can go.
Thank you. Thank you.
We just got to get changed real quick?
Yeah. Yes.
Great. We're going to go change and we'll be right back.
Okay.
All right, cool. Thanks a lot. You've been a great help, man.
Thanks.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to Sexy. Oh my God, they are sexy, sexy men. Ashton Kutcher and Pete Diddy.
How y'all feeling up there? Thank you, Rosalind Sanchez.
That's what I'm talking
about.
That was hot.
That's what I believe in. Okay, here are the nominees for the best villain. Yeah.
What would you do if you were given the crown?
If I was to be crowned best villain, I would rid the world.
Borg went so tragically unrecognized and without whom this award would have never been possible.
I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them blue for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Yes, I think to myself.
This one's for you guys. We'll never forget you.
Here are the nominees for Best Virtual Performance.
Oh, dude, our action figures are here.
Whoa, mine has super kung fu dance action.
I wonder what mine does.
I smell like poopoo and pee-pee.
Awesome.
Best Virtual Performance.
Roger.
Scooby-Doo. Scooby-Doo.
Your mom eats cat poop.
Roby-dooby-doo.
Dobby, Harry Potter and the Chamber of Secrets.
You shall not harm Harry Potter.
Dobby is free.
Yoda, Star Wars Episode II, Attack of the Clones.
Lost a planet, Master Obi-Wan has. Only the Dark Lord of the Sith knows of our weakness.
Kangaroo Jack, Kangaroo Jack.
Love the jacket, Charlie.
Come on, people. Throw me a freaking bone. I have a son.
Gollum, the Lord of the Rings, the Two Towers.
First is my friend.
Bones us! We don't have any friends. Murderer.
And the best virtual performance is...
Okay. Gollum, Lord of the Rings, Two Towers.
Hi everybody, my name's Andy Serkis and I'm delighted to receive this award on behalf of everybody who brought Gollum to life. Can't actually be with you this evening because we're down in New Zealand completing more shots on Gollum for Return of the King. I'm actually in the motion capture studio where we do a lot of Gollum. I would like to say a big thank you to all the MTV fans, to the Lord of the Rings fans, and to everybody who worked on Gollum. It is a complete marriage of skills.
You're a liar! And the thief, it's mine. I won it. It was me. We only won because of me.
And me. MTV is my friend. My friend.
You don't have any friends. Nobody likes you.
Dobby likes me.
Dobby. Dobby's a f***ing f***.
That's enough, Gollum.
Piss off, Circus, you stupid fat with a f***ing turd.
I'm not fat.
We're not gonna thank anyone, no. Not you, not MTV, and not those pics of pretty pendants at Water Digital. And Peter Jackson, my precious. Who do you think you are, you f***ing hack? Shame on you! Shame on you! Go f*** yourself! Not listening! Frankly, nothing can compensate for the long hours and low pay and miserable experience we've had making this f***ing movie. And if you think a little tub of gold popcorn is going to remotely make up for everything we've suffered, you're sadly f***ing mistaken. You're all bastards! MTV sucks! We hate you all! Good night.
About you, Amanda Bynes.
Are you guys from heaven?
Up next, Harrison Ford, Josh Hartnett, Demi Moore, Keanu Reeves.
Nobody look at Harrison right now.
Go behind the scenes of the MTV Movie Awards at MTV.com.
Get those cameras out of my face.
Hollywood homicizzle, Harrison Fizzle Zord, and Jizz Off Heart Nizzle.
The nominees for Best Performance by a Female are certainly easy on the eyes.
Yeah, but did any of them make the Kessel Run in under 12 parsecs?
Harrison, your lines are right up there. What are you doing?
Right there. Don't worry about it. You never understood what I'm doing. Just keep reading.
Okay, but their beauty is far surpassed by the talent they consistently bring to the screen.
Snakes. Why did it have to be snakes?
Are you gonna do your part or what?
Go on.
Right, okay, well anyway, 5 deserving women. 1 is... This is your part there, I think, there, Captain.
Get off my plane!
Okay, anyway, here are the nominees for Best Female Performance.
I think I'm bleeding.
What a couple of bitches.
Best Female Performance. Reese Witherspoon, Sweet Home Alabama.
Nobody talks to my mama like that.
Halle Berry, Die Another Day.
I'm a girl that just doesn't like to get tied down.
Are you gonna get me off this thing?
Kate Hudson, How to Lose a Guy in 10 Days.
Think of it, what a Fern.
You let it die.
Kirsten Dunst, Spider-Man.
Wow, great reflexes. You'll think I'm a stupid little girl with a crush.
Queen Latifah, Chicago.
Welcome, ladies. Spice it up for mama. She'll get hot for you.
Harrison, you forgot my favorite one. It's... I had an affair with her. I did not kill my wife. Right. And the best female performance is... Do you want to open the envelope?
Kirsten Dunst, Spider-Man.
right, ladies, we have a special performance backstage after the show with Ashton and P. Diddy after that tattoo thing. That's right. I'd like to thank MTV and all of you guys for voting for me. Thank you guys so much. And thank you. And thank you to Sam Raimi and Laura Ziskin and Tobey Maguire and Willem Dafoe and everybody on the movie. And yeah, thank you guys. And I hope you guys like the second one. And thank you for giving me 2 popcorns tonight. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Demi Moore.
When a male performs at his best, it can make you laugh. When a male performs at his best, it can make you laugh. It can make you cry. It can make you sweat. It can even make you weak in the knees. Here are 5 men who've actually managed to hit the spot. And the nominees for Best Male Performance.
Best Male Performance, Eminem, 8 Mile.
You were a star until I served you.
Tell these people something they don't know about me.
You gotta stop living your life like this.
Leonardo DiCaprio, Catch Me If You Can.
You're gonna have to catch me. You see all this money?
Very good,
Vin Diesel, Triple X.
Oh, you gotta be kidding me.
I live for this!
Viggo Mortensen, The Lord of the Rings, The Two Towers.
It is an army bred for a single purpose. Destroy the world of men.
Tobey Maguire, Spider-Man.
You tried to kill Mary Jane.
I've been like a father to you.
I have a father. His name was Ben Parker.
And the winner is Eminem.
I got mail. Now you go, lady. Yay! Yay! MTV, it's my birthday. Boom, boom, boom. Yay! Now you go, MTV. Yay! Thank you. Yay! I got mail. I got mail. Boom, boom, boom. Yay! Now you go, lady. MTV, thank you. Yay!
Next, Keanu Reeves and the award for Best Movie and the thrilling conclusion of the 2003 MTV Movie Awards.
Yeah, baby.
Ladies and gentlemen, Keanu Reeves.
The 5 films nominated for Best Movie are so good, I can only think of one word to describe them. I'm not going to say that.
Is there a problem, Mr. Reeves?
Yeah, I'm not going to say that word.
Yeah, this is Scooter. Yeah, he's not going to say the last word. Right. Okay, copy, I'll try.
Please? No.
That's a negatory. Hey, look, don't yell at me, dude. I'm just a frickin' PA. He's the one. I said one. You didn't hear me because I made air quotes with my fingers, so I didn't have my finger on the button. Well, yeah, well, you know, I know you'd like him to say it. I'd like health insurance, but that's not gonna happen either. All right, Mr. Reeves, hi. I'm Scooter.
Hey, Scooter.
How about if you say the first part, and then I'll say the word?
Okay.
Okay. We're green. Repeat, we're green.
The five films nominated for Best Movie are so good, I can only think of one word to describe them.
Whoa.
Okay, that's a wrap on Scooter.
Here are the nominees for Best Movie.
We've only got 9 seconds!
Whoa, we can make it.
We can make it!
Hey, how's it going?
Sorry, guys. Sorry.
Sorry.
Best Movie.
Justin, go get me some goobers.
Spider-Man. Oh. 8 Mile. The Lord of the Rings, The Two Towers.
And the best movie is The Lord of the Rings, The Two Towers.
Accepting on behalf of The Lord of the Rings, The Two Towers, Elijah Wood, Billy Boyd, and Sean Astin.
My God, my God. I just want to say I'm sorry to MTV on behalf of Gollum. That dude gets out of control, and I'm sorry.
Well, Peter Jackson should really be here to accept this, because this is quite a lofty responsibility for us, but you have a couple hobbits from the Shire, so I hope that'll do.
Yeah, we're missing one hobbit, but
this is true.
I'm sure he'll be happy that we won. It's such an honor as an actor to be in this kind of movie. Thank you very much.
Thank you, guys. Thank you so much.
Ladies and gentlemen, you ain't gotta go home, but you gotta get the hell up out of here. Good night.
To the future!
Joel, can Joel hear me?
Yeah.
If you do that shit again, I swear to God, I'ma come back in.
It's gonna be a long day.
I met David Beckham.
How spontaneous.
Sorry.
I had a great time.
I'm not just blowing smoke up your ass. That's his job.
They ain't called me the Oracle back in high school for nothing.
Woo! I love you, Morpheus! It's me, T-Bone!
I'm gonna punch you right in the balls.
God, the bane of my existence right here.
It's all about MTV. I'm still thinking about 50 Cent.
I got to see 50 Cent perform. I'm so excited. That was awesome.
Oh, she whispered in my ear something about the reverse cowgirl. I don't know what that is.
She's crazy.
What's happening, hot stuffs? Daddy's right here.
You're gonna be so gassy.
You're really choking me, bitch.
Oh, sorry, dude. Tell me.
I am.
This is candid.
Jesus, look at the guns on that black man.
Who's been drinking?
I gotta get shorty on you. I don't know what I'm talking about.
I can say big words!
It's a forbidden ass. You can't teach that.
It's like teaching a lion how to hunt.
Sorry, Joel.
Damn, y'all still in here?
MTV Movie Awards, bye.
That's it. I'm out.
Okay, it's go time.
We had a great time. Joel, everybody MTV, thank you.
Yes.
Thank you for the opportunity.
Yeah, it was a dream come true. Thank you very much.